ਓ ਆ ਜਾ ਮਾਹੀ ਆ ਜਾ ਮਾਹੀ ਆ ਸੋਹਣਿਆ ਵੇ ਆ ਕੇ ਅੱਜ ਮੇਰੇ ਗੱਲ ਲੱਗ ਜਾ ਤੂੰ।
सो आई होप तुम लोग को मेरी आवाज़ अच्छी लगी हो एंड पाजी थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कमिंग। दिस इज़ अ वेरी स्पेशल पॉडकास्ट फॉर मी बिकॉज लास्ट टाइम जो मैं पॉडकास्ट कर रहा था दैट वॉज द टाइम वेन यू नो मैंने लिखा था बट आई वॉज बिहाइंड द कैमरा एंड यू नो आई एम स्टिल नॉट अर्निंग एंड समथिंग बट दिस इज अ वेरी स्पेशल पॉडकास्ट फॉर मी बिकॉज यू नो थोड़ा टाइम पहले मैं पीछे था कैमरा के एंड अब मैं आके खुद का कर रहा हूँ। सो
वेरी गुड कांग्रेचुलेशंस
एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कमिंग। सो स्टार्ट करते हैं। सो यू नो सबसे पहले हम लोग को ये करना है कि यू हैव गिवन लॉट ऑफ इंटरव्यूज लाइक 50 इंटरव्यू तो दे दिए होंगे बट यू नो व्हाट आर द कॉमन क्वेश्चंस जो आपको पूछते हैं।
कॉमन हाउ डिड यू स्टार्ट हाउ डिड निंदी स्टार्ट सिंगिंग विद यू इज नूपी गोना बी डूइंग म्यूजिक आल्सो सो दीज आर वेरी वेरी कॉमन वंस मेजॉरिटी आर ऑल कॉमन नाउ आई थिंक।
ओके ओके
सो वी विल ट्राई आवर बेस्ट बी डूइंग समथिंग क्रेजी टुडे।
या इन इंडिया फाइनली तो कुछ नया है कि मतलब
lots of things happening yeah. Obviously India is such a moving country now. I think the thing is I always tell everybody India is a monster on itself. It doesn't need any input from outside of India. Everything is in India. So you know shows happen in India, people can earn in India, music is growing in India, everything is happening in India. And I think now because with the internet that's opened up thanks to Jio and whatever hell has been going on, everybody's watching on the net and seeing more music internationally. And the international music that people are seeing, watching, the influences they're getting from this, we have to catch up. So I have to now, before when I used to first come to India, people was always behind. So I would come in with something new. And people are like, oh, wow, Paji, you're doing something new. That's crazy, crazy, crazy. Now what's happened is I'm coming to India and I'm catching up to people in India. So people are already doing things who are moving forward. So this is, you know, there's new stuff that is happening. Yeah, I'm coming back to your point. I've got some awesome new artists that I've signed and I'm releasing. I'm more into the hip hop, obviously. Still doing Bollywood, still working with Akshay Paji. So we've got some more songs coming again. Yeah. So it's never ending and the clothing line and so on and everything.
Yeah, so we'll come back to hip hop and Akshay Baji and all. But so life ka ek topic jo chhoot hi nahi raha itself, like everywhere the question is like RDB. Theek hai. And we know like RDB is a huge hit. Theek hai. So and now you have started Man's Music. So we just wanted to know ki when you left RDB. Theek hai. So RDB was and is still a huge empire. So when you left RDB, what was going on in your mind? Like, what difficult over, right? So,
of course, it's difficult because the idea was not to leave RDB. So I think, you know, sometimes what happens is the media and the way it's written, it seems as though I've left RDB. And you know, when it happened at the time, there was a lot of people who went against me and said, you know, why are you doing this? Why are you leaving RDB? Why are you breaking off RDB? This is wrong. Because there were so many people, I was very passionate about RDB. They was emotionally connected to the brand. So it wasn't the fact that I left. It was just the fact that after my older brother passed away, there couldn't really be another RDB. Because it's like, you know, with, for example, I'll give you the Beatles. When John Lennon passed away, there was really no Beatles properly. Yeah. You know, without John Lennon, there couldn't be a Beatles. Yeah. So for me, without Kulipaji being around, and me and Kulipaji was making all the music. I was composing, I was singing, I was making some music. Then Kuli would make beats, we'd make music. So when we was doing this, I lost one half of my partner. So if I was to make music and claim it as RDB, I think it would be false of me to do that. I think that would be wrong of me to release music as RDB without Kulipaji's input being there, because realistically he was the originator, he was the one who really put RDB on the map and gave us these ideas. Okay, yeah, let's do jungle, let's do a garage, let's mix hip hop into this. He was a creative, crazy genius, and that not being around, I can't say that, okay, Tiga, he's not around now, I'm going to be the creative genius and I'm going to make a song as RDB and release it. Yes, we could. But then if, let's just say the song flops, tomorrow I release a song as RDB and the song goes out and everyone says, yeah, what a bakwas gana, look, you know, Kuli is not around and they're releasing rubbish like this. This degrades the brand. It actually tarnishes the brand. So instead of me wanting to keep releasing things as RDB and then possibly even basically messing the brand up, I'd rather just say, okay, there is no more RDB and I'm just going to become Mange Music. And that was the hardest thing in my life to do, to actually say there is no RDB and I'm now Mange Music, because then everybody would automatically hate me and say, yeah, you just wanted to go solo, you're looking for your own promotion and marketing, you're just trying to publicize yourself, which wasn't the case.
Like in the beginning it would have been difficult for you now, because chhoda to aisa laga ki yaar khud ko bhi wo hoga na ki shit, what I'm doing, am I doing something right? Or
I questioned myself also, thinking, should I do this, should I not do this? And me and my other brother Serge, we sat and we quarreled and we argued over many things. But in every business in the world, when there's family involved in business, there's going to be arguments regardless. So, you know, this was an ongoing thing that was happening, and I just came to a point where I just said, okay, you know, I don't want to tarnish the brand RDB. I don't want to abuse the name RDB. I don't want to keep saying that. Even if you look at most of my social media, I don't keep saying RDB, RDB, RDB. Yeah. And when I take bookings or anything like that, or marketing or promotion, it's always Mange Music. And that's just so RDB can stay as epic as it was.
Yeah.
When you say RDB, you think Alu Chaat. You think of all the RDB big, big songs. I don't want, you know, my songs that I'm releasing under the same bracket, because it should always stay there. It should stay and remain at the top.
So talking about your brother, so RDB is still going on, right?
Yeah, he's still.
And they are still doing shows and stuff. So what's your take on that? Like, do you still have some conversation or something ki nahi RDB abhi bhi chal raha, or do you?
Nahi, to be honest, there's not much of a conversation happening between me and him, because he feels as though he wants to just keep using the name. Because he's not releasing music, obviously.
Yeah.
But he just wants to use the name for shows and so on. And I think that's where we come to a roadblock. Okay. Because I don't think we should be using the name to gain financial gain.
Yeah, there was some problem in Aaja Bhai also, where Singhis Bling mein again Aaja Bhai aaya tha.
Right? Aaja Bhai came in Singhis Bling, yes.
There was some problem I heard about it.
Yeah, but that's a lot of like copyright issues and blah, blah, blah. There was a lot of red tape behind the songs and who owned the songs, because it wasn't, RDB never really owned the songs. They were owned by another record label called Untouchables.
Yeah.
Untouchables released all the songs for previously, like all 360 songs of ours are released by Untouchables. So there was a lot of red tape behind that release. And I think they'll constantly, it will always be there. I think because the brand RDB should not be abused is my main thing. And what he wants to do is he wants to use the brand RDB for his own financial gain. Now, I'm not going to stop him, because at the end of the day, everybody has to eat and everybody has to live. And he has a daughter, he's married, you know, like I don't want to stop him. He can carry on doing whatever he needs to do. And I just carry on doing things as Mange Music. I have the respect for RDB in my own sense, and I'm happy.
Yeah. That's great. So, so you know, even you started new two times, like first RDB and then Mange Music.
Mm.
And in the beginning, it's like everyone wants to follow their passion, and there's this blood rush ki nahi karna hai, karna hai, and there's a lot of excitement.
Mm.
But then as time passes, now you have got so much of experience with you.
Mm.
So, kabhi aisa laga ki nahi, ab growth stagnant ho gayi hai ki it's just making music just because of earning or surviving.
I think it's not stagnant. I think what happens is you come to a point in life where you have to play catch up, because everybody else is also moving just as fast as you. So I come back to my other point, where I used to first come to India and everybody was behind.
Yeah.
So now what's happening is you come to India and everyone's doing what you was doing before, and they've caught up to what you was doing.
Mm.
And now they're moving. And at the end of the day, I'm not getting any younger. I'm getting older as I come. So for me, for my career, the position that I feel as though I'm in right now, if I can make music to make people happy, I will do it. If I can create an artist to fulfill his life of what he wants to do, being an artist as a rapper, a singer, jo bhi hai, and help him promote him, then I will do that also.
Mm.
And, you know, obviously everybody has to eat. We all have to make money. Nobody's going to eat without making money. So if we can make money and do business in the right way, in the clear way, that's all I want to do. I like to, if you see on my social media, I promote everyone and anyone that I think is good.
Yeah. So also, everyone, if your work is good, he replies himself, because maine khud ne DM kiya, unhe do bar reply karte hai. So
bilkul. Absolutely, 100%.
That's great.
I think this is my way of being connected with the audience, with the fans, with yeah. everybody. And my main thing is that if I can help promote somebody else, even if I'm not gaining anything, it's okay. It's not a big deal. Majority of people, especially in this business, in this line of business, and even people who become something yeah. afterwards, they will only do things strategically and scheduled. That, oh, ha, okay, so if I do this, or if I post this, what do I gain out of this? Will I get money from this, or will I get this from this? And I don't think there's any need for that. I think if we work together this way and promote everybody, everybody wins.
So as you said, Ki, before you used to do something and then people used to catch up with that.
Hmm.
Okay. And before there was Ajamai, and then you guys started, you were the pioneers of collaboration, like Shera the Com with Ludacris, and then Snoop Dogg, Sing is King, and lot of collaborations. Okay. So there was this time first Ki Ajamai and Bahut Saari Cheezein, then there was Bombay Rockers ka
Bombay Rockers huge.
Yeah, then collaborations, and now to Hindi remixes.
It's big.
I'm not personally liking those stuff. Mm-hmm. Okay, thoda bahut.
Hey.
But so what is the next big thing? Ki abhi next big wave kya hai? Because you know there was this era, har cheez ka ek era ho raha tha. So what's the next big thing which is gonna come?
I mean, if I could tell the future, I would tell the future, but I can't tell the future. Realistically, I think from what I've seen, there's a full circle, and that's exactly what's happening right now. See, back in the day, even in Bollywood music, they also used to sample or take an old song and blah blah blah, and then they used to mix it a little bit. And then now in my career, for what I've done, from Ajamahi moving to Ajamahi to making Alu Charts to hip hop to the Bollywood stuff, what's happening is it's going full circle round. I'm finding people today writing songs and making songs the same way we used to make them back in the Ajamahi days. So some of the biggest writers who are releasing songs from Punjab now, or putting them into movies and so on, they're writing in the same style as what we used to do back then. And I think that is just like fashion. In fashion, if you go to Gucci or Louis Vuitton or go anywhere now, they're using the same cuts and old styles that they used to use in the 60s, 70s. Yeah. So they're recycling what was big then. Nobody's really initiative is to make something crazy new anymore. They're taking something old and bringing it new. And that was a fashion, and it's happening again in music. So I think this recycle thing will happen for a while until they've rinsed and finished everything that's recycling. And then they'll start creating something new again, and then it'll do it again. Then the new stuff will come, and then the old stuff will be old, and they'll recycle it again.
So, Anna, what's your process? Like, see, whatever you guys brought was new. Like, even the collaboration thing was... Everyone knew crazy. Collaboration was ki abhi to sab karte, but then before, like, you guys started. So what was the process behind it? Ki kya soch ke, kya idea hai, sab kaise hua?
Simple. It was basically, let's do something that nobody else is doing.
Yeah.
Because in India, was there collaborations happening? No. In Bollywood, there was no collaboration big happening. In hip hop, there was no big collaborations from East and West happening. So we was thinking, let's do something that people are gonna say, wow. Whether they accept it or they don't accept it, let's do it because it's different.
Yeah.
This is exactly why we started doing garage music in Punjabi music. The Bhangra and garage was never done before, and we mixed that for the UK, and it created something new. So the collaborations really honestly happened because, I mean, Akshay Paji really pushed us for a collaboration, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
He at that point, he was doing Sing Is King, and he said, you know, let's do a collaboration. Bring some hip-hop guy onto one of your songs. So we said, all right, okay, okay, we'll bring a hip-hop guy, and then we work it out, and Sing Is King became one of the most epic anthems of all time.
And people are like still dancing on them. Sing Is King, Ajamahi, then Alu Chaat, still very much active. Yeah. So, you know, coming to music production and stuff, while you're producing music, so what are the key elements that every music producer should, you know, keep in his mind, or what are the key elements you are using while producing music?
Okay, when making music, the one advice I can give anybody is, if you have the ability to learn properly, first of all, learn how to play keys and keyboards and everything properly, if you can, if you have somebody who can teach you this, because I never did. I never learned any music from anybody. I just picked up every instrument and just messed with it until I could play it. But if I did learn it properly, I don't know what I would be able to make today. It'd be something crazy. So if I can just pick up a few things and learn it, you guys can do also. So anybody who is making music, first thing is to learn the music, learn patterns, learn beats, how to play an instrument. Because if you can play an instrument, whether it be drums, tabla, anything at all, you get the rhythm sense. Or keyboards or keys, you get to know about sor. Yeah. So these things are very, very important first. And then second, listen to every genre of music. Don't be just like, I listen to hip-hop. I don't want to listen to anything else because I only listen to hip-hop. You're never going to get inspired from just listening to the same things over and over again. If you're listening to, people like J Balvin today, he's making reggaeton music in Spanish, but he's crossing to hip-hop, he's crossing to house, he's crossing to DJs, he's now making reggaeton. You know, these things happen because they're listening to different genres of music. So I listen to everything from rock to metal to everything, because you never know where you're going to get inspired from. And then that once that inspiration comes, and you never know when that inspiration is going to come. It could be when you're sitting on the toilet and you get an inspiration. It could just be any time, but listen to different things.
So talking about genres, like there are a lot of people who don't recognize the genres. Bahut log aisa hota hai. So what are the basics? How do you recognize a genre?
I think you need to have some music sense to understand a different genre of music. I think for anybody who doesn't know, but they're probably listening to different things and they want to listen to more, the easiest thing is just go to Spotify or go to thingy and just go to under genres and find different genres and click on each one and just find, okay, I'm listening to a lot of hip-hop, but you know what? Yeah, I want to hear some metal. So go to genre and go to rock and just find some stuff that is in rock. And you may find influences from rock that you could put into hip-hop.
Yeah.
Post Malone was really a South rapper, singer from, like, he was a hillbilly. That's where he came from. He was doing all the, you know, the guitar hillbilly songs and he turned that into rap. So his influences came from a completely different genre, but into rap, and he became a super hit.
Yeah. So and everyone sir also keeps doing beat pe baat hai. Right.
I need
so,
to do another one. I haven't done one for a while.
Yeah. So yeah, I saw all. I think so. You've done three.
I've tries. Done three. Yeah.
So I've seen all of it, and you know he replies and he also shares a lot of knowledge about it. So if you guys want to, you know, ask something about music or stuff, you guys can, you know, be active on Instagram and ask him on beat pe baat hai. Was there a point in your life where it came ki nahi ab music chhod de do? Yeah. Something else. Which
I think when Kulipaji passed. When my older brother passed, that's when I actually was going to quit. And that was the end then. At that point, I said, okay, you know what? I'm not going to be making music anymore. I don't even think if I can do it. I don't think, like, you know, every song we made together. So me and him used to be in the studio all the time. There was no computer that was turned on without me and him both being there. So once you lose that, you kind of feel as though sometimes I've lost, am I capable of doing it? Am I really capable of making the same level of music that we was making then on my own? So I questioned myself. And at that point, I did think, okay, you know what? Time ho gaya. I think, you know, I think we should just call this quits now and not make any more music. Because Serge was not making music. He can't produce. So I was like, I think I'm done. No more making music, and we move forward. And it was actually Nindi, my wife, who kept saying and pushing me and said, listen, why are you giving up? Why are you giving up on yourself? You have got more talent than you can even imagine. You're not thinking that you have this talent. You keep thinking that I only have this because Kuli's also there, because blah 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 blah. You can do it yourself also. And she really uplifted me, and I said, okay, chalo, let's do this.
And what was one thing ki, you know, one statement ya one day ki nahi aaj aisa hota na ki, because it would have taken time, right? Ek hafta do hafta bola hoga shayad, but aisa ek din ki nahi ab really believe ho gaya ki karna hai.
I think because I had, just as Kulipaji got diagnosed with cancer, he was going downhill, unfortunately. So he wasn't spending time in the studio, and I was having to be in the studio to make the music. And when I used to make music in the studio, I used to just have Kulipaji sit with me there. And even though he wasn't giving much input, because he was, you know, unfortunately, the cancer was taking toll of him. So he would sit there and he would just listen, and I would be making the music and doing the thing. Now, the one song I sat there and I made all on my own with Kulipaji sitting there was Whistle Bajao from Hero Panti. And then when that song actually released, because during the time of me saying, I'm giving up, Whistle Bajao had released. And the success of that song gave me that pump, gave me the boost. Wow, I actually made this song. I composed it, I put it together, and I could do it on my own. So let's move.
That's great. And Ajamai was also the idea was of Mansur.
So, all the compositions of all the RDB songs was my composition.
So except for RDB, like Man Music has also done a lot of things. Swag Mera Desi. Like bahut saare logon ne to hip hop swag mera desi this ne start
kiya. Bilkul.
And then
that became a groundbreaking like stamp.
And desi hip hop too. After Desi Hip Hop 2, like, it created a buzz. Among the youth, it was like a buzz. But then there are a lot of, you know, senior rappers like Bohemia and all. So you always say you want to collab with Yo-Yo Honey Singh, Bohemia, and it's going to be crazy. But Bohemia at that time was dressing you. And then Jay Hind coming and stuff. So what was that accordion? Actually, kya tha?
See, you know what? I think it was a misunderstanding, to be honest.
Yeah.
Hence why, if you notice that I didn't really reply on anything and I wasn't really going crazy and fighting with anybody.
Yeah.
Because it was just a misunderstanding. And Jay Hind, I've known Jay Hind for a long time. Long, long time, well before RDB was in that time. So it wasn't something that, you know, it was a personal vendetta against Jay, or Jay had a personal vendetta. I mean, me and Jay are talking now, so everything's completely fine. There's absolutely no issues between any of us now. But I think at that time, because Desi Hip Hop was coming out, and obviously Bohemia was not on Desi Hip Hop, and the name Desi Hip Hop really came from Bohemia. Yeah. And obviously his fans were going to be, what the hell are you making Desi Hip Hop without Bohemia? You are a traitor. You cannot do this. And I think people just put the masala musala together and created this beef. And it just got hyped and hyped and hyped, and it turned into that.
A lot of posts by them and then videos and all. So, but you know, you guys can get together, and there's this circle which you're in inside.
Of course, yes.
So, I've seen not only one podcast too, but all the interviews. Ki you have said any two artists that you want to collab is Honey Singh and Bohemia. So, what is it? Why did you not?
I don't know
because it's gonna be crazy.
I think everyone's just busy doing their own thing. See, there has to be an initiative from somebody. So I'm like, you know, I'm open to it. Let's do it. If somebody is down and ready to do this, then, you know, we all know each other. We can make it happen. Everyone can connect with each other through phones or DMs or anything. You contacted me through DM, it happened. So it can happen. If you guys want to do it, then, you know, reach out and let's do it. But I think somebody needs to take that initiative to actually make it happen.
What really happened with MTV Hustle? Because we saw your story was something.
So MTV, see, I mean, I support anything to do with hip-hop, of course. And MTV Hustle is, I would say it's Raftar's baby, because Raftar is really, like, he's holding the fort on the whole situation. And he's done a great job, and he's doing a brilliant job with highlighting different people and so on. The only one thing that I didn't like, and it wasn't Raftar's fault, to be honest, it had nothing directly involved with him, but it was definitely the MTV people, that they should at least let us know before they're cutting somebody's verse out. So this didn't only happen with Sadi from KKG, it happened with somebody else as well. I can't remember their names, but it also happened with them. So because I only found out afterwards, after Sadi's verse was cut when it went live on TV, and I posted the post, everybody else started hitting me messages, DMs, saying, but it also happened with blah, 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 it happened with so-and-so, it happened with so-and-so. So, you know, it was really, it's disheartening because, you know, Sadi, all three of them work very hard to what they're doing. Any rapper does. When you give them a platform like this, especially TV, I mean, if you and three friends got together, you went on TV, you filmed, and then you say, okay, and MTV tells you it's going to be airing at 8 o'clock, you will sit with your whole family, correct? Your whole family will be waiting to watch you on TV. So when all his family was there, and his whole verse has been cut off, and he's not even doing anything on stage, that very, it's like, it's disrespectful. At the same time, it's degrading for him. So I just posted a simple post out, and Raftar messaged me straight away and said, "Bhaji, this is gonna get sorted out. It's not my fault." And I agree, it's not his fault. But I had to put him in because he called KKG there.
Yeah,
it wasn't Nuclear who called KKG there, and it wasn't Raja Kumari who called KKG there. Raftar personally called KKG to have them there. So I put them in, so making sure that this is done properly. And that's it. As long as everything is done professionally, it should be no issue.
But this happens every time. It's mostly your production, your channels call. And
channels are like... the biggest. I mean, I think what happens is channels do... I mean, now it's aired. Now, yeah. So they've re-aired it now and everything's fine.
It's added, yeah. Because yeah. Now if you see the...
reply, of course, one add one of them. So it was going to happen. I think, you know, these... anything to do with TVs and channels and media, they always play these games, and that's just the way it works. They said that there was some audio issues with his verse, so they re-recorded it. Chalo, maybe there was some audio issues, but whatever it was, it got resolved, so I'm happy.
Okay. You're the only South Asian who has done most international collabs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, it's like two things. So, what was your motive ki bringing international market here mm-hmm. or taking the Indian market there?
I think initially was to bring the international artist to India.
Okay.
Because like I said, Akshay Paji, when he said, I want to bring a rapper yeah. on the song. The first thing we thought is, can we afford it? Can we afford to bring a rapper into India? Because, you know, it's easy to say, collaboration karenge, but who? Who's going to be paying them? How is the money going to be exchanged? Blah, blah, blah. Yeah. So we needed to make sure that there was a production house in place where they could be paying for this, because Snoop Dogg is not going to come for like, yeah, cha pani chaklo and fucking out. So we had to make sure that, okay, he is basically paying him, he's happy, management's happy, publishing is right, everything's done. And we use that initiative to say, this is your opportunity to get into India, to Snoop. So coming back to your question, we did it because we wanted to bring international to India.
Yeah.
And we knew that if we bring one to India, they'll all want to come to India. Now, because India, the music scene has grown so big and so many people are doing collaborations and everybody's performing here now. Mm. I think every artist, I think Katy Perry's here next month. So
Wiz Khalifa also.
Wiz Khalifa yeah. game, yeah. So it's crazy. Mm. Now people have realized that, okay, India's a huge market. They can make lots of money there. It's good business sense. So they're all coming over here. But initially, we only made it just to bring that audience into India.
And second thing, yeah, international collabs, like, how did you get it? Because Ludacris, Snoop Dogg, then I think so Sean Kingston.
Yeah, we just did Sean Kingston lately. Yeah. We did T-Pain really, also.
Yeah, but T-Pain, yeah. So how did you get in that circle? Because...
long story short, I moved to Toronto. So I was very close to people in the US that could connect me with certain people, management and blah, blah, blah. And it's all networking. It's all networking and relationships. So when I used to go and do shows, I used to connect with certain people who'd introduce me to so-and-so and blah, blah. Oh, by the way, he works on him, or he does this, he does this. And with Snoop, we got to know his drug dealer. And his dealer, who was dealing him hash and weed and everything, he was like, yo, I can get Snoop. I'm like, yo, okay, you can get Snoop. And he's like, yeah, he's my boy. You know, I deal with him and da-da-da, et cetera, et cetera. So funny enough, the whole deal happened through that guy.
So coming to a third segment,
mm-hmm.
it's like, bahut zyada serious baat ho gayi, it's called Thodi Bakchodi.
Okay.
Theek hai, because we don't want it to go for rapid fire, because abhi sab kar rahe hain. Pehle humne bhi kiya tha.
Theek hai, yeah.
So what's the weirdest fan request you got? Because you've been performing everywhere. Theek hai. Bali wali bhi gaye sab jagah perform karne.
Weirdest fan request was the girl who wanted to marry me. On stage. And she brought a ring.
And...
obviously, I was already married, so okay, I'm so sorry. But I'll sing Aaja Maahi to you. So I sang Aaja Maahi to her and she was very happy.
But uske baad Nindi ma'am ne phone check kiya hoga.
No, it's okay, it's all good.
So, acha, you live in Canada. Hmm. So what's up with Canada and Punjabis? Matlab,
I think Punjabis have just taken over Canada. I mean, I don't know what's going on there. I think what's happened is Canada has obviously given everyone visas to come to Canada.
Yeah.
And the first people to get out of India is usually Punjab. They're the first ones out and they've landed in Canada. So it's taken over Canada now.
Like, meko aisa sunne mein aaya ki ATM mein bhi English, French and Punjabi.
Punjabi,
bhi hai.
Yeah. Even the signposts actually say in Punjabi. Like if you, roads are named in Punjabi also.
Oh shit.
It's crazy. It's becoming like the new modern Punjab.
So, okay. So it's like, artist and clients.
Hmm.
Wo matlab aisa ek jodi hai, to bahut zyada annoying jodi hai. Theek hai? We know ki clients kaise hote hain. So one experience of yours ki isme, you know, client ne aisa irritate kiya ki matlab And how did you deal with that?
There was one client, this is a long time ago, and we did a wedding in the UK. And you always get these clients, we've given you money to perform, okay? That means I own you.
Yeah.
Anna. So we had this situation. We was on stage and we was performing. We did a good hour and a half. And at the end, he's like, "Dol bajao, dol bajao." I'm like, "Yaar, I don't play the dol. I sing. We have the band to play the dol." He goes, "Nee, aap dol bajao." I was like, "I'm not going to play the dol." And he's like, "You have to carry on playing the dol right now." I said, "Yeah, we finished. Everything's done, dusted." And he actually got a big pile of money. And he threw the money on me and the dol that was on the floor. And he's like, "I'm paying you. Take this, play." And at that point, I just said, "Look, thank you so much. Thank you for having us. You can take your money. You can give it back to whoever else you need to do. But we're not going to carry on performing anymore." And we left. So we get those type of clients also.
Yeah.
And, you know, you have to control the situation. You can't start fighting with them and start, you know, do anything stupid. But the thing is, you control the situation. And if you're disrespected like that, for me personally, it doesn't matter how much money you give me. If you're going to disrespect me like that, I'm out.
Paji, dekho, yaar, ab abroad mein rehte ho, theek hai? Toh apne goro ko gali diye kabhi, sach bajana.
Nahin, actually, no, gore no.
Kisko bhi aisa hota ki jisko samjha nahi ho.
Maybe while, when driving. Yeah, haan, ho sakta hai.
Kaun si, please.
Oh, usually the panchos and oh, oh, that's the standard. That's the standard in Punjabi, you know. Panchos is everything.
Oh, yahan pe bhi hota.
Ha.
Sahi hai, par udhar acha na, udhar kisi samajhta nahi hoga na.
No, wo samajhte hai. Yeah, even the gore, the kala, even kale understand what kala is. Oh. So you say you pancho kala, they were like, "Oh, what did you say?" It's like, "Oh shit, okay." They even know what kala is.
Oh shit, shit. What are the three most common mistakes every music producer does?
Thinks they're the best. That's the first problem.
Okay.
Because anybody who's making music, if they think that their music is the best, that's the first thing that you should stop doing. Because you should always feel as though I can learn more. That's the first thing. Second is, like I said, understanding music, learning the keys and things and these things. A lot of people make the mistake where they don't learn the keys. And I get beats. I mean, I did beat Pivate, and I get so many beats sent to me where the sor is over here, the beat is going this side, and there's no, everything is like a khichdi of a beat. But they feel as though, and the message is there, I made the craziest killer beat, please can you get Raftar to rap on this beat? Now, they believe in themselves that they've made a crazy beat, obviously, but this is the mistake they make, is that understand music first. You can't just, because you have a laptop, you've made a crazy beat. You need to understand how to make that beat.
Yeah.
And I think finally, as a mistake that producers make, is possibly using wrong rappers on the wrong beats. So a lot of people I find, they'll make a beat and they'll have some guy rap on there or sing on there, and it doesn't match the beat. It doesn't fit on what it's doing. So just be careful in how you're producing the music and understand the music first.
Okay. See, there are two things. Because personally, for me, when I listen to music, sometimes there are times you cannot identify kiska music hai, but you know, there are two people jiska music aisa sunte na, in starting 4 seconds mein sunte hi na pata chal jayega kiska music hai. That's Yo-Yo Honey Singh and that's Manj music.
So thank you, it is
the truth. Aisa nahi ki just because aap aaye ho iske liye, theek hai, because but there, starting ke 4 seconds mein pata chal jata hai. So what's that, what do you think, matlab aapke dimag mein aisa kya rehta hai jab aap music banate ho, ki क्या सोचते हो बनाने के टाइम में, एंड ऐसा कैसे हो जाता है कि यू नो पीपल जस्ट गेट टू नो कि हाँ ये ऐसा ही है?
आई डोंट नो एक्चुअली, आई थिंक आई जस्ट ऑटोमेटिकली लाइक एक्सीडेंटली क्रिएटेड अ साउंड. इट्स नॉट समथिंग दैट आई सेड ओके, लाइक हनी, ही वाज कैलकुलेटेड. He knew that he's going to go in this style and he's always going to go Yo-Yo Honey Singh. Yeah. And that's his signature. Done, khatam. Everyone knows it's Honey Singh. With me, I didn't have no signature or anything like that. It was just a sound that I created that automatically became that style. Just like RDB. RDB created a style of sound.
What's your advice for them? Like the budding artists, because abhi, after 10 years, it's their time, right? Mm-hmm. So,
I think my advice to people who are getting pushed, who are getting pushed by parents, is to obviously do whatever you feel as though is right, and definitely push your passion of music. Push your passion of music and make your parents or make the people around you who are pushing you, make them proud. But don't do it in a rush. I think the people, what happens, the problem is that people want that 1 minute of fame very quickly. They think, okay, theek hai, ek gana release ho gaya, done, wicked, well, what? Oh, nahi chala, yaar, it didn't work. Now what do we do? Don't give up. I mean, one song, two songs, three songs, four songs, it doesn't make any difference. But just keep releasing stuff until you feel as though I'm getting some. And I think everybody around you will automatically say, shabash bhai, you know, this is good, this is very good. Or this was okay, TK, this was okay. Get the input. Use people as input. And you'll grow automatically. Just take criticism. Take criticism. If somebody says, yeah, that rap was rubbish, don't say, oh, you don't know nothing. Say, okay, TK, what was not rubbish about it? Okay. What was it in there that you didn't like? I didn't like this. Okay, TK, maybe work on it. Take criticism. It's very, very important.
Okay. So thank you so much, Paji, for coming. Thank you so much. You know, our channel's name is Creatively Crazy. And trust me, honestly, you are one of the Creatively Crazy guys
we have met. Thank you so much.
And we have been listening. So, just please tell them to subscribe. Like, haters, if you still want to...
Haters, definitely subscribe. Because we need haters.
And for haters, it's like panchot.
Yeah. Subscribe.
And those who think they know, you know, those who liked it, please subscribe to our channel.
Yeah, okay. Absolutely. Definitely subscribe to the channel.
Thank you so much.
This is what you guys are doing is creating the movement that he needs. Yeah. And this is the push that everyone needs. So haters, subscribe because I want to see you hate. And lovers, definitely subscribe.
Thank you so much.